I'm sorry it took so long for us to come back. We have an opportunity to come back here today because, you guys know we're starting a new church in New York, Queens, and we've been working on that discipleship week. During the weekdays, we're meeting on Sundays for people who didn't have a church, but we realized that when you start Sundays too early, and this is what all the experts say too, you start to lose momentum, so we pulled back a little, and I went on traveling preacher mode. So that's why I can be here today. I just really thank you guys so much for inviting me in and allowing me to come here and share God's word. It's always been my heart to share whatever God has given me with you, especially because I really consider you guys close, people that are really generous and I really care about and really love as a whole, not just individually. And so it's really good to be back. That's what we've been doing, training with our Redeemer Presbyterian Church's incubator program. Trying to gain as much support and prayers as possible. And please pray for us. When you're praying for your lunch at school or whatever, or at work, and you just remember us for some reason, maybe it was a message or a song, and you're like, Lord, just please be with them and help them. That would be much appreciated. We really need it. We've had some difficult times, but I guess this isn't the time to talk about that. This is the time to talk about the word. If you want to know more about that, talk to me in private. So let's go to Judges chapter 6, verse 7. Let me just grab one more. I've been preaching at different congregations the last several weeks or so, several months. I don't know why I get nervous when I'm with you guys. It's like I have something to prove or something. I don't know what it is. I just get up here and I'm like, this is it. We're gonna do this. I'm with you guys, I get kind of jittery. I don't know what it is. Alright. So Judges chapter 6, starting in verse 7, let's stand for the reading of God's word. I'm reading from the English Standard Version, so please hope you don't get distracted. It's a different translation. Judges chapter 6, verse 7. When the people of Israel cried out to the Lord on account of the Midianites, the Lord sent a prophet to the people of Israel. And he said to them, "Thus says the Lord, the God of Israel, I led you up from Egypt and brought you out of the house of slavery. And I delivered you from the hand of the Egyptians and from the hand of all who oppressed you, and drove them out before you, and gave you their land. And I said to you, I am the Lord your God. You shall not fear the gods of the Amorites in whose land you dwell, but you have not obeyed my voice. Now the angel of the Lord came and sat under the terebinth at Ophrah, which belonged to Joash the Israelite, while his son Gideon was beating out wheat in the winepress to hide it from the Midianites. And the angel of the Lord appeared to him and said to him, The Lord is with you, O mighty man of valor. And Gideon said to him, Please, sir, if the Lord is with us, why then has all this happened to us? Where are all his wonderful deeds that our fathers recounted to us, saying, Did not the Lord bring us up from Egypt? But now the Lord has forsaken us and given us into the hand of the Midianites. And the Lord turned to him and said, Go in this might of yours and save Israel from the hand of the Midianites. Do not I send you? And he said to him, Please, Lord, how can I save Israel? Behold, my clan is the weakest in Manasseh, and I am the least in my father's house. And the Lord said to him, But I will be with you, and you will strike the Midianites as one man. And he said to him, If now I have found favor in your eyes, then show me a sign that it is you who speak with me. Please do not depart here until I come to you and bring out my present and set it before you. And he said, I'll stay until you return. So Gideon went to his house and prepared a young goat and 11 cakes for the ephah flour. The meat he put in a basket and the broth he put in a pot, and brought them to him under the terebinth and presented them to him. And the angel of the Lord said to him, Take the meat and the 11 cakes and put them on this rock and pour the broth over them. And he did so. Then the angel of the Lord reached out the tip of his staff that was in his hand and touched the meat and the unleavened cakes. And spire, and fire sprang from the rock and consumed the meat and the unleavened cakes. And the angel of the Lord vanished from his sight. Gideon perceived that he was the angel of the Lord, and he said, "Alas, O Lord God, for now I have seen the angel of the Lord face to face." But the Lord said to him, "Peace be to you. Do not fear, you shall not die." And then Gideon built an altar there to the Lord and called it, "The Lord is peace." To this day it still stands at Ophrah, which belongs to the Israelites. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
You can see it.